Books never ask our age, but understanding and analyzing them does require a minimum level of cognition. So due to this reason, I have come before you to present with you with 10 book recommendations for the children who are of age between 10 to 14 years or beyond. All the books certainly intrigue you more and more. So why delay? Let's get started. Hello everyone, thank you so much for watching ATP, that is Among the Pages, where I talk about the books and the content written among their pages. If you want to explore more bookish content on my channel, do make sure to like, comment, share and subscribe. Well, before I proceed with the video, let me give a small disclaimer saying that all these books were my personal opinions, and in each book which I have read personally and felt that this can be read by children of age from 12 to 14 years or beyond. These were not recommended in any website, nor any Goodreads, nor any YouTube channels. These were all completely my opinion. So even if you find any such new books to be included into this, then please let me know down in the comment section. All the books will be reviewed individually in my channel and will be put henceforth. So make sure you subscribe to my channel. The first book which I'm going to recommend is Eragon by Christopher Polony from The Inheritance Cycle. Well, this book certainly amazed me because it introduced me to the genre of fantasy and fiction. I was flabbergasted knowing the matter of fact that the author was only 17 years old when he has written this book. This book was also made into a film in 2006 with the same name, but I also suggest please read the book way before you watch the movie. I completely acknowledge the fact that the book had a whole lot of words which would take into an imaginative world rather than the movie itself. The next book which I'm going to recommend is The Earthsea Trilogy by Ursula L. Guin. Well, this book completely ameliorated the fact that I love fiction and fantasy genre a lot. The most important fact in this book is this book has the whole plot written in another archipelago which was considered to be the Earthsea or the Earthsea Cycle. This book has completely optimistic points in the first book, and gradually throughout the plot gets negative or darker. Well, I have recommended this book to children because it introduces them to the whole new plot and a whole new ideology of the author in putting the characters in a magical world where they discover the new realms of magic and new avenues of how the plot has been proceeding. The next book which I would certainly recommend is Holes by Louis Sacher. Well, this book completely is based on the protagonist who himself is a small boy named Stanley. Well, the plot proceeds with Stanley being put in a separate center where because of the charges of theft. The plot continues where he understands how the things have been going on, and there are a whole lot of social aspects which were also subtly put into the words. I have recommended this book to children of this age because this gives a greater scope of them in understanding the world and how the people have been treating children or adults. The vocabulary and the literature part of this book is very easy, which helps the children in understanding the book a lot more easier. And the most important point is the protagonist in this book himself is a small kid, because of which the children can easily get attracted and inclined to this book and read it. The next book which I would certainly recommend and the most anticipated one is The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. Well, we all know that this book was made into a Bollywood film in 2014 with the same name, and also as a Hindi Bollywood film with the name Dil Bechara starring the late Sushant Singh Rajput. Well, why I have recommended this book to children is only because the plot is so subtle and is very requisitioned to understand and to make children understand the pain which a person feels when he or she is suffering from a terminal illness. The protagonists in this story, Hazel and Augustus, both of them are facing the terminal illness with cancer, where Hazel has a thyroid cancer and Augustus has osteosarcoma. Though this book completely falls in the genre of romantic tragedy, I have suggested this book to children only to let them understand the pain of a person who is facing the terminal illness and how this world actually treats them. This book certainly needs a read because of its very small, low usage of vocabulary, but beautifully framed sentences and how the plot goes with a lot of poignancy. The next book which I am going to recommend is the most anticipated one, and that is Percy Jackson series by Rick Riordan. Well, this book has a plot where Percy persuades himself into the knowing the matter of fact that he is the son of the ocean god, that is Poseidon. The chronicles follow how he tends to find that Kronos, the titan of time, is growing and getting his forces ready and is waging a war against this world. Well, this book is so much of fiction and has a lot of easy peasy words which would certainly incline anyone into the plot. Well, I think I need not say more about this because many of them know this, but yet this is certainly a must read book. The next book which I'm going to recommend is The Chronicles of Narnia by C.S. Lewis. Well, this book was also much anticipated and is well known and was also turned into a film starring the same characters and the same name. But the most important fact of this book is it was actually written for children and it has beautiful illustrations put into this book. If you are not reading this book and watching only the movie, then you are certainly missing something. While you're reading the book, you certainly feel that you were into the plot and actually witnessing the characters which are moving before your eyes. You would certainly feel that while you're reading the novel, the movie is actually playing before you. But I would certainly say the movie could be a lot more better than our imagination. The plot proceeds with the four major protagonists, that is Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy, and the Ice Queen, and of course, Aslan, our most favorite character. The plot proceeds where there is a mystical world called Narnia and has an eternal winter because of the Ice Queen. Well, the introduction itself intrigues us more into reading this book, so why not give this book a try? Before you watch the movie, please make sure that you are reading this book. The next book which I'm certainly going to recommend is, well, this is not a book, this is an author, that is Sudha Murthy. Well, she is one such famed figure who need not given any introduction. Any Indian, all the Indians know her, and her writings are also equally good. Being a philanthropist, added to the fact she is an ardent reader plus a wonderful writer. If you are not reading her pieces for children, then you are certainly missing something in your childhood. All her books ranging are not only for children but also for adults who seek the importance of parenting. The book How I Taught My Grandmother to Read, The Golden Temple, The Lost City, all these books are certainly so intriguing that you certainly are absorbed into the plot. Well, I would certainly recommend reading Sudha Murthy's works because it gives us a wider scope and also instills into us the actual meaning of true India. This book would certainly give us the value-added facts, how Sudha Murthy ji's had her childhood, how her grandmother used to teach her, how the values which she had incorporated into her, the values which she had tried to put into their children, and the subtle art of parenting, and the way she has been portraying India, her village, the tradition, the culture, and the systems which were then prevailing, and how she has openly opposed the caste discrimination or illiteracy and all. So these books are also must read. All the books which I just cannot list out by Sudha Murthy ji is perfect readers. Well, the most intriguing book which I'm gonna say now is Where the Mountain Meets the Moon by Grace Lynn. This book is completely a fictional book where the protagonist is Min Li, a small girl child who seeks to reach the god of moon, the old man of moon, and seek the answers of what actually happiness in this life is. Well, this book is not certainly inclined to philosophy. The plot completely takes you into a whole roller coaster ride of understanding various perspectives of various creatures and how the curiosity of a little girl has led her to the greatest success of her life. This book has a whole collection of all the Chinese folklores which the author, that is Grace Lynn, has listened from her mother during her childhood. So this had completely a roller coaster of all the Chinese mythological fiction and the folklores, and how she had gracefully put all of them to weave a plot which would certainly intrigue us. Now certainly the next book which I'm going to recommend is Any Book by Amish Tripathi. This Indian author is simply awesome. The way he has been retelling the greatest chronicles of the Indian history, may it be Ramayana, may it be that is faced by Lord Shiva, the immortals of Meluha, the oath of Vaiputras, the secret of Nagas, Sita, the warrior of Mithila, Ravan, the orphan of Aryavrata, the enemy of Aryavrata, all of them are so intriguing, and they are completely the retelling of the Indian way of proceeding with classics. So if you want your child, if you want to incline children towards Indian culture or embracing the various facts and the texts and the plots of the Indian history and Indian way of explaining things, you would certainly love his way of retellings. And let me say, this is not mere a retelling. Amish also weaves a plot which would certainly assist him in proceeding with the plot. Though he had made certain smaller changes in Ramayana, in contrast to what Valmiki Ramayana actually says with us, we could certainly be agreeing with both of the plots, as both of them were completely persuadable and are completely readable. So please don't omit Amish Tripathi, because he is one of the stunning author I have ever seen. I am suggesting this book by called Wings of Fire by APJ Abdul Kalamji. Well, this is the book which we all have read, and this book is also a must read. It covers all the information of what a student of India must be knowing, and the basic facts, and how actually his story, that is the story of the author, that is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, has been going, and how and what he wants the children of India, that is the future of India, to be, and how he has been practicing ways so that he can educate children of India to become a noble and a worthwhile citizens. So this book is also a must read. If you like my way of reviewing and explaining bookish content, please encourage me by liking, share, subscribe my channel, so that it would encourage me in reading more and this whole world becomes a book universe. Thank you.